The farms that we bought in Tasmania, they were in a degraded condition, particularly in respect to the effluent management. And that's really, you know, when you talk about effluent management, that means, you know, you don't want your effluent running into waterways, and it's, you know, it's very serious, and you have to take it very seriously. So we've been working very closely with the regulator, with the EPA, the Tasmanian Dairy Industry Authority, to really take our farms up to a level of best practice. We want to set a new standard for the industry and have things really running as seamlessly and as positively for the environment as we possibly can. So it's, you know, we view the regulator as a partner in this and in the journey to getting dairy in Tasmania to you know, a really high standard.
So obviously in Deira, you know, we're producing milk, and at the start of the season, on the 1st of June, their processors announce what their milk price is, which is great. So when we start the year, we actually know what we're going to get paid. And this year, there's a lot of increases every few days that's going up because of the short supply of milk and the strong demand. But there's other aspects to dairying. So we have female calves that are born every year, and we also have male calves that are born every year. And traditionally, there hasn't been a market for those animals. So we're actually moving to use beef in our farms. We're already doing it. So we use good beef breeds over the cows, and we keep those calves and we grow them out, and then we sell them on to backgrounders. So it's a whole another aspect to the income of dairying. It works really well together. There's a really strong demand for it. There's been a real shortage of beef, not just in Australia, but, you know, in the world. And obviously, you know, we have these calves every year, so it's a great supply chain. And the beef industry is, and the processors are starting to recognise that they need to partner up with dairy farmers. So it's a great value add to the dairy business that we have. In the past, dairy farmers have been very much price takers rather than price setters. You know, we haven't, the process have basically come to us and said, well, this is how much we're going to give you, and then we have to manage our businesses within those sort of parameters. This year, things have changed. There is a real shortage of milk, and it's not just in Australia, it's actually in the world. The demand is growing sort of at 2%, and the production is actually reducing. So for the first time ever, we've seen opening milk prices, minimum milk prices on the 1st of July, and they're just going up all the time. So pretty much every day I'm having to look at my phone and the prices have been increased. And the dairy farmers are actually holding off signing their contracts, waiting to see how this is all going to play out. We all have to have our contracts signed by the end of June, but we don't know what the final price is going to be. So, you know, people recognise that milk and dairy is a really important part. It's a staple for everybody. You know, the nutritional value that you get out of dairying is hard to find in any other product. So it's a really good time to be invested in dairying, to be involved in that. It's exciting. And one of the reasons, you know, if you want to talk about, you know, scale of our fund and what size are we looking at getting to, we're sort of looking at between that sort of 80 to 100 million litres of milk. And the reason behind that is if we do actually want to do something with a product ourselves, we would have the ability to do with that size of milk and that amount of milk, we'd actually be able to look at doing something ourselves rather than reliant on selling our milk to somebody else. So there's a lot of things happening within the industry. It's a super exciting time to be involved, and I think as an investment, I think it's just an absolutely awesome one.
One of the most exciting opportunities that is in front of us right now is an opportunity that we're partnering with a group called Innovating Energy, and we are building a biogas electricity generator, waste to energy project in Nowra. It involves 19 dairy farms, which is hence why we're involved, taking the manure from those farms and taking it to a biodigester, an anaerobic digester, which creates energy. So we can create electricity, gas, base load, which will run 24/7. In addition, what you get at the end of it, after you put the manure in, you've got the methane is abated, so it's not going up into the air, converted to energy, and the digestate that comes out at the end of the process is then given back to the farmers as fertilizer on the to be placed over the pastures. So it's really this amazing project, this, you know, the circular economy that we're all working towards right now. So from this, where, you know, it's this waste converting to energy in the agricultural space. This is really, you know, this is done all over the world, all over Europe, in America. It's, you know, it's not new, but it is new for Australia. So there aren't many of those here, and we're very proud to be partnering with them and being part of this initiative. So the first one in Nowra will hopefully be operating, you know, within 12 months. And we hope to be doing the same in Tasmania on our farms. We just see huge benefits to the community, to, you know, renewable energy. And it being baseload energy, it doesn't require the wind to blow or the sun to shine. This is running 24/7. So it's true, you know, coal replacement, which is really, we're very proud to be part of it.